To me, cancer's a verb. You're cancering. It's not something the body gets, it's something the body does. And so my job as a cancer doctor is not to target the cancer cells, to change you. So we are now hopefully going to embark on a new way of defining the individual and looking at the whole, not just the cancer cell, but looking at the whole body and the whole organism, all of us, to try to get the best way to treat this horrible disease. My job isn't just to treat cancer, it's to change how we treat cancer.
I think David Agus is an incredible doctor, he's an incredible man. I think what he's done is amazing. I feel like the very fact that what they're building here in Santa Monica, that it's just going to change so many people's lives. And there is no one on the planet who hasn't been touched or affected in some way by this horrific disease.
Two of my aunts had breast cancer. My mom had breast cancer twice and melanoma. My aunt, the youngest of them, at 63, lost her life. She had breast cancer and she got over that, and then she got brain cancer and she fought a very good battle. So tonight is all about research and raising money for it and honoring the doctors who've done it, and that's why I'm here.
I am the perfect person to host tonight because honestly, I hate cancer. I do. I hate it. I hate cancer so much, I wish cancer would get cancer. The people we're working with here tonight, you are surrounded by the smartest people in their field. We are talking about doctors, nurses, physicists, biologists, biochemists, mathematicians, molecular biologists and chemists. So I am incredibly honored that they asked me to help them because my job is basically singing in a car with celebrities. For all the times that you made my heart break, for all the pain that you left in your wake, you blocked out the sun on my darkest day, and even worse, you made me run a 5K.
You did. I owe this man so much. The lives of several members of my family have been saved because of the work of David Agus. It would be wonderful if that institute could be built. It is something we need, an interdisciplinary institute where mathematicians and engineers and scientists and doctors can work together, can collaborate, looking at vast amounts of data, trying new experiments, discovering things that were invisible before to our eyes. If we had such an institute, the revelations that would come from that institute would save countless lives. So I'm kind of curious. The institute sounds really nice, but expensive. How much would something like that cost?
I'd say about $200 million.
What? $200 million? I'd like to announce tonight that I'm making a gift to the University of Southern California to start this interdisciplinary medical center, research center, center for the care of people who have cancer, with David Agus as the head, that will be built nearby in Santa Monica, California. This seems like an appropriate way for me to say thank you for everything you've done for my family and my friends. I will be eternally grateful.
Wow. $200 million. I work at CBS. I'm lucky if I earn that in a year. Ladies and gentlemen, time for some entertainment now. Here to dazzle us with her amazing voice, please welcome the former Kansas City Chiefs middle linebacker, Kristen Chenoweth.
Troubles melt like lemon drops, away above the chimney tops. That's where